要有人经过啊。
有没有老师要往上面？
哎，麦克风给我。
那边有一
些。走吗？工作方便。
因为会有老师要下去，
所以呢，
他在那个先不要留。
这样
不
太好。
同学，同学，哎，看我这边，看我这边哈，这里还蛮冷的，衣服要带着，好，然后要联系，然后我们有三个单元嘛，哈，要有三个罐头，就是掌声啊、反应啊、笑声啊、聆听啊等等。好，那注意哦，每个人都会上镜头，啊，现在已经在拍，好，不要看了别人，不要挖鼻孔，哈，好。好，来注意哦，注意哦，每个人都有哦。好，哎，你们有睡得很好吗？有人在打哈欠哦。哎，很好，哎，这个，因为你们没有学校的名字哦，会不能讲。看椅子哦，看椅子。好，来，那准备要来掌声哦，哈！嗨，贝贝，要有精神哦，当作热身，来，三、二、一。这边不用，哎，我们先休息啊。休息一下。很好哦，每个人有可能都第一名哦，非常好。好，再一次哦，第二次哦，来，三、二、一，开始。好，停，好，休息一下哈、哦，左右看一下，看头发有没有乱的啊，来，互相看一下。妆有没有没有化好的啊？对，头动一动。好，哎 ，OK 的哦，这个单元你们的罐头的那个掌声 OK。那我们换这一边，我们看老师这边表现怎样哈、哦？老师还有同学一样，我们都看椅子这里。好，早餐应该还蛮好吃的啦。看这里哦，假装同学在这边表演了。好，来准备啊、哦，掌声啊，一样哈、哦。好，来我们分两三次啊、哦，来，三二一。
停，
然后休息一下。好，来 ，one more time，one more time， 讲一下英文 ，one more time， 哈、哦，来，一、二、三。然后我
，Hello everybody， 大家好，谢谢大家。首先呢，非常恭喜大家哦，过五关斩六将呢，通过层层的考验，来到外交小尖兵英语种子赛选拔活动总决赛的现场哦。那先请大家给自己还有所有小尖兵们一个热烈的掌声，谢谢自己、队友以及可敬的对手们。哇，谢谢大家，都非常的有精神哦。 很好，要继续保持这样子的活力哦。那过去一年来呢，我们也发现呢，国际上出现了很多议题，比如说是能源危机啦、空污问题，或者是说恐怖主义横行啊、气候异常等等，再再都让我们感觉到，其实不管是世界上哪一个角落发生的事，已经都变成全人类的事了。那面对这样的议题呢，我们要如何以台湾出发，用爱来进行国际关怀呢？而对于新世代的青年们而言，你们参与国际事务的心愿景以及心中的期待又是什么呢？今天呢，这些高手中的高手们即将现身说法，来到现场，告诉我们台湾是怎么样有爱，又要怎么样来进行国际关怀呢？104年度外交小尖兵超强英语种子们，接下来的舞台就交给你们喽。Are you ready? Very good。好的，那在我们呢进行比赛之前，我们就要先来看看这18支优秀的队伍是怎么样透过他们超强的英语能力、出色的团队精神以及厉害的国际视野来过关斩将，通过环敌，对不起，强敌环伺。对不起。好。对不起哦，对不起哦。就超大声的意思。好，Are you ready?
Yes.
Very good. 好的，在进行今天比赛之前呢，我们就先来看看这18支优秀的队伍是怎么样透过他们超强的英语能力、出色的团队精神以及厉害的国际视野，一路过关斩将，从强敌环视中脱颖而出的呢？一起来看看。先介绍评审，等一下再等你。现在来介绍今天的评审，国立成功大学外语系陈昭芳教授，亚洲大学外语系陈英辉教授，台湾艺术大学戏剧学系张晓华教授，国立成功大学外语系石林教授，国立政治大学英语学系马怡莲教授，好，请第一二三队携带身份证件前往第一准备区。好，接着说明比赛规则哦。今天总决赛竞赛呢，总共分为三个阶段。第一阶段为团体表演，第二个阶段为团体英语演讲，第三个阶段是益智问答竞赛。每一位参赛者都可以获颁全国决赛证明以及纪念品一份，18队都可以获得奖状。前10名的队伍另颁发给奖金还有奖杯，前3名的队伍还能代表台湾出国参访。外交参访哦。接下来我们掌声欢迎教育部国教署赖文静专门委员为大家致辞，欢迎赖专员。
各位同学、各位评审啊，与会的来宾，大家好。
好。
首先在此感谢各位来到我们。这边共同共襄盛举，我们今天一起共同来参与教育部跟外交部一起共同办理的104年度外交小尖兵种子队的一个选拔活动的决赛。那在这个历程过程中当中，各位呢在100多队的一个参赛过程历经了数月的一个准备。今天终于能够在此胜出来参加今天的决赛。那各位在比赛过程当中呢，也经历了很多的准备。 在过程比赛中各位能够经历过我们的一个英文的一个表现，以及我们在参赛过程中的一个胆识，以及我们这个团队精神合作的一个培养。未来在各位在未来的一个旅程中，希望他们这些都是造成可以培养我们各位在旅程中的一个注意。那今天我们感谢各位的一个参与，也希望今天各位在此比赛过程中能够很好的佳绩。最后祝福大家，谢谢。
谢谢，谢谢赖专员，谢谢你。好，专员的鼓励呢，希望大家都能够有好成绩啦。那我们接下来就要进行今天的比赛喽。请第四队携带证件到第一准备区，第一队请上台。第一队的表演题目是 Turning Point, Education is Power, 计时开始。
Mr. Lee, I'm afraid I cannot come to class anymore.
Why? Is there anything wrong?
Because my parents, they have been arranging my marriage. They want me to marry a 40-year-old man.
What? How can a 13-year-old get married?
But it happens in our country every day. Like my cousin, she got married at the age of 11, and now she's pregnant.
So she's going to become a mother?
When I saw her, I was terrified. I don't want to be like this.
Don't cry.
I don't want to be a wife and a mother. And this man now. What should I do?
Maybe you can try to tell your parents that you have learned so much at school. And if you continue to receive education, you may end up with more possibilities.
Possibilities? Okay, I will try.
Where have you been? You should stay home. Soon, you are going to be married, remember?
About that, Father, must I get married so early? I'm only 13.
What are you talking about?
But, Mama, many girls in our country get married at your age. I was even younger when I got married to your father.
But that's not for me. I like to go to school and I love to learn.
School can't do any good to you.See, what happens when you let her go to school?
At school, I realized that there are other possibilities. If I continue to learn, I may achieve something. Just like Malala from Pakistan. And maybe I can make you proud as the sun can do.
You can make me proud now by getting married. That's it. Don't ever think about school again.
Grandma, don't cry. But you know, this is our tradition.You really don't have any other choice. Just accept it.
But I do have other choice. There is only one person that can help me. Mr. Lee, I need your help.
What happened? You talked to your parents?
Yes, I did. But they still insisted.And my father even forbade me from coming to school. It is hopeless.
Don't give up. Look at this. A 10-year-old girl filed for divorce and succeeded. There is still hope. Maybe we can shoot a video of your story and then upload it to the internet. Hopefully, we can draw people's attention to child marriage and make a difference. It might be risky, but are you willing to share your story with the world?
Yes, I am.
Hello, I'm Sam Lee from Taiwan. I have been working as a volunteer teacher in Yemen. 1/5 of the teenagers cannot receive education. One reason contributing to this is child marriage. Today, a potential victim is trying to tell you her own story.
I'm Rama, 13 years old. I'm arranged to get married, but I don't want to. I want to go to school, and I want to learn.
This is really brave of you. What encouraged you to do this?
My teacher, Mr. Lee, told me a lot of things, including the story of Malala, a female fighter for education. I was deeply inspired and decided to stand up for myself. I hope that my story can make a change on this issue, so less girls like me can enjoy the simplicity of childhood and the pleasure of education. Thank you.
According to the survey, girls are 6 times less likely to become child brides when they stay in school. Education can be a life-changing opportunity. Let's them be girls, not brides.
Hi, Mr. Lee, I'm back.
Rama, I'm so glad to see you again. And this is?
This is my father. Guess what? The video successfully aroused people's concern and urged the government to take legal measures against it. Many people, therefore, are greatly influenced, including my father.
Maybe education can really do something good for you. And maybe someday, you can really make me proud.
I will. And Mr. Lee, I couldn't have done this without you.
Oh, I'm more than happy to see that I make a difference in people's lives. That's the reason why I'm here. Love from Taiwan.
请第五队期待证件到第一准备区。第二队的表演题目是 Everyone Can Make a Difference， 计时开始。
Hello everyone, I'd like to pass on a story about three friends who accidentally helped save the road. It began not long ago when the trio set out on an adventure. Row, row, row your boat.
Hey guys, long time no see, how's everything going?
Great, it's been a long time.
Yeah, really. We're heading up to explore an unknown world. Wanna go?
You bet. Let's get going.
Now, unfortunately, every story always seems to have an unexpected twist.
Row, row, row your boat.
Ah! Oh my God!
When the trio wakes up, they find there are a mysterious world surrounded by garbage and dirty air.
Where are we?
I have no idea.
Why is the land and the sea so polluted?
I know, there's garbage everywhere. Where are we?
Who were you and where are you? Not a ghost, but merely a poor man trying to survive.
We're sorry, sir. Please tell us what the date is today.
Today is November 15th, 2115. You don't even know the date.
We have traveled through time 100 years.
But where are we?
We were sailing on Pacific Ocean.
You're in Taiwan. As you can see, it is not nearly as beautiful as you remember.
Why not? What did humans do to destroy the environment?
Well,
Over the last century, people on Earth didn't concern themselves with their environment. They never considered the benefits of reusing, reducing, and recycling. Even worse, factories discharge their industrial sewage and exhaust pollutants without filtering them first.
That's horrific! Had we known, we could have stopped those things from happening.
Absolutely. How about we return to 2015 and revert this catastrophe?
Great idea.
But first, we must take some photos to prove that what we have witnessed is true.
Come on, old man.
Wow, girls, that's really awful.
Okay, everyone, let's go.
Great, now let's go.
Save the road.
Oh, what? Jump in.
No,
let's go.
The trio enter the whirlpool in reverse direction to return to the year 2015.
We can't allow our future to become what we have seen.
I know. We have to come up with some ideas to save our Mother Earth. Let's build a network platform on environmental protection through talks with our young people around the world.
Good idea. And I can use social media to contact NGOs like Greenpeace to see if they will offer assistance. Their mission is to save the Earth while maintaining sustainable development.
Hey, and we can launch a flash mob campaign to clean the beaches and upload the video to Instagram.
Great idea. Although we are young, we still can change the world.
Absolutely. We are all sharing this place we call Earth. So, let's do it!
Let's do it!
Surrounded by garbage and dirty air, I feel alive again. So remember, how we act in the present will dramatically affect our future.
Yeah, and by working together, we can all make a difference.
Now,
thank you for your attention.
请第五队携带证件到第一准备区。第六队，不好意思，请第六队携带证件到第一准备区。第三队，请上台。第三队的表演题目是《A Heaven in a Flower》，计时开始。
Do you sleep well? Do you have enough to eat? Do you want me to?
I know how to take care of myself. I'm the student here. I'll call you later.
嘉豪，嘉豪
，Who was it?
Oh, my mom. She never treats me as a grown up. Do your parents treat you like a child too?
Never.All of us kids are taught to take care of ourselves at a very early age. I'm only 14 and I have to work.
But children your age aren't supposed to work.
But I had to. For my family. I have friends polishing gems, weaving carpets, rolling cigars, or even breaking stones at quarries. My brother has to stitch 30 footballs a day, but he could never afford to buy one.
It's not fair.
Jaha, thank you for everything. I never thought that I could have a chance to sit in a classroom and learn.
Oh, it's nothing. Actually, I'm wondering...
What is this book about?
Oh, it's the poetry of William Blake, one of my favorite British writers. Listen to this. To see a world in a grain of sand, and a heaven in a wild flower, put infinity...
A heaven in a flower? But I have to pick jasmine flowers every day since 4 o'clock in the morning.
4 o'clock? No kidding.
I don't see any heaven in these flowers.
Oh, Anika, try to think positively. What would your heaven look like?
My heaven? Well, if I could simply go to school every day, it would be a dream come true.
Jiaming, is this what Jiahao's talking about? You're covering child labor in India now. What? Every year, there are tons of jasmine flowers to be made into perfume and tea.
And over 60 million children are forced to work under $6 per month.
How can they survive?
That's horrible. Mom, look what I found in the storeroom.
Oh, your dad's underpants made by
underpants.
Your grandma. He says they're family heirlooms.
Ew! What are they made of? Net weight, 20 kilos?
They're made of flour bags.
Flour bags?
In the 1960s, the U.S. distributed food and provided us with medical care. They even gave us English lessons.
Oh, that's what Jiahao's doing right now in India. Don't you think it's our turn to help others?
Right. He's doing something meaningful.
Not only him, I'm also getting involved.
You?
Jiahao and I are now designing an app to help the child laborers in India.
An app?
Yeah, and learning from the computer class.
Hey, Jiaming.
Hi, Jiahao. Have you received the app I sent you?
I did. I love the icons you designed. I have a few functions to add as well. First, I'd like to establish an online platform to raise people's awareness. Volunteers like me can share what they have learned by writing articles or posting the pictures.
That's cool. I'm also thinking to put in a donate button. That way, people have a direct channel to aid these children financially.
That's awesome. At the same time, we can build a website to encourage people to purchase products directly from the farmers.
We can also establish a website to show the companies that use child labor and tell people to boycott their products.
That's a great idea.
Hey, this is important too. Why not add the shortcut to UNICEF, United Nations Children's Fund? People can simply dial the number and report if they find any child being mistreated.
Great job, Mom. Jiahao is on the phone.
Let me talk to him. Jiahao.
Hi, Mom. This trip has made me appreciate what I have. And I also discovered a passion for writing. I want to unveil the unfairness in the world and encourage people to do whatever they can to change it.
I'm so proud of you.
To see a world in a grain of sand and a heaven in a wild flower. I never thought that heaven could be found in a flower. But now, I know how it can be possible through people's generosity around the world. Thank you. This encourages me to pass on this love, to help others also find their own heaven.
Little drops of water make a mighty ocean.
Little grains of sand make a pleasant land.
A small change can make a big difference.
Be the change you want to see in the world. Thank you.
请第七队西队。 请第七队携带证件到第一准备区。第四队请上台。第四队的表演题目是 Feeding the Planet, Farming for Tomorrow, 计时开始。
The 2015 World Expo is being held in Milan, where nations underscore the significance of food shortage. Our story begins when two enthusiastic Taiwanese teenagers arrive at the expo to understand more about this issue.
Ah, here we are at the Swiss Pavilion!I heard that is the talk of the town.
Yeah, because of free souvenir.
Free? Free stuff, rocks. On the double, man. Wow, there are apples, salt, coffee, and water.
Yeah, there's still plenty of souvenirs left.We should be able to get some.
Hey, visitors are free to take away or consume any amount of the product. Awesome. Hey, why are you doing that?
Yeah, that's inconsiderate.
So what? I got here first.
Excuse me, stop arguing. You're disturbing the other visitors.
Sorry, but this guy here...
I know. He has just demonstrated the main concept of this pavilion.
Well, what do you mean?
This pavilion emphasizes the seriousness of global food shortage. The limited food displayed here reminds us that if we exhaust our natural resources, then future generations will have nothing left.
I understand, but could it be that serious?
It is. According to statistics by the United Nations, a person dies of hunger every 10 seconds.
What's 10 seconds?
Oh no, that's horrible! Can we do something about this?
Maybe we should promote some farming techniques to increase production.
Well, sustainable agriculture might be a solution.
Oh, we can produce food forever and ever. And also, if this farming method is practiced in every corner of the world, then it may change everything!
Great plan! Yeah!Hey, I have an idea. We are both from Taiwan, right?
I'm sorry for being a jerk earlier, but could you please count me in? I'm from Taiwan too.
Sure thing. So why don't we set up a Taiwanese pavilion right here to share our ideas? We can take action ourselves.
Yes, we do care about global affairs and want to make a difference in the world.
Awesome. I could search for information.
I could find farmers for advice.
Then I can gather the materials we need.
Off we go!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Taiwan Pavilion. Today, we would like to share with you some ways to address the upcoming food shortage.
Through investigation, we suggest that sustainable agriculture might be a way out.
Excuse me, but how does sustainable agriculture help? It doesn't seem to increase the production of crops.
With sustainable agriculture, the land will not be overexploited by chemicals and would stay fertile.
It should be able to yield a stable supply of food.
Presumably for eternity! And food shortage will become a thing of the past!
Sounds convincing, but are there any successful examples to support this idea?
Indeed there are! A local company in Taiwan, Buy Nearby, is one of the successful pioneers.
They sponsor farmers to help them switch from chemical fertilizers to the natural ones.
The company buys the farmers' products regularly at reasonable prices.
They then sell the products themselves to promote the concept of sustainable agriculture. Isn't that fascinating?
That's amazing! Those are definitely game-changing ideas that will make a huge difference.
we hope to propose a solution for nations facing agricultural problems. What we do today will translate into a better tomorrow for all of us.
A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. We believe that we, the younger generation of Taiwan, ROC, can make a world of difference by taking the first step. And the first step is to reach out and care.
Thank you for watching.
请第八队携带证件到第一准备区，第五队请上台。第五队的表演题目是 Glory of Taiwan's Energy Tech Lights the World， 计时开始。
Hi everyone, I'm your leader Vivian. Welcome to join Borderless Love Club. We keep focusing on every nook and cranny in the world. That's the reason why I founded this club. I hope you can make joint effort for our society with us. That's all my speech of greetings. Thanks for your listening.
Hello, the TV news.
What's up?
There's a report of the electricity shortage in our diplomatic ally, Burkina Faso.
If we offer lighting device to our ally, people can do house chores or even study in the dark. Maybe it's time for us to do something.
There is sufficient sunlight in our ally. We can improve the status quo of Burkina Faso.
But we're just students. Can't do that?
How can you know it's impossible? Before putting into practice, don't be hesitated.
Taiwan's most well-known solar energy technology is able to help them, isn't it?
But where can we install the solar panels? And how can we afford the facilities?
Aha! We can narrow the solar panels and set them on the backpacks so that they can absorb sun's ray more easily for generating electricity. Moreover, we can ask for some sponsors from businesses. Some entrepreneurs in Taiwan.Are enthusiastic about public welfare.
Great!
Knock, knock. Come in.
Nice to meet you, CEO.
We are Borderless Club. We have a pioneering plan. Through your assistance, people in Burkina Faso are able to use electricity.
Oh, you guys have to offer your plan first.And I'll consider if this will be practical.
We hope that we can raise about 2,000 solar energy backpacks.
Solar backpacks?
Yes.
I've been in the solar energy field for decades, but never heard of this stuff.
Yes. This is a conception after putting our heads together. In short, it's a solar portable device.
How creative you are. But actually, would it be feasible or it's merely a fantasy? I'll never find such an impossible proposal.
No, it's definitely not just a fantasy. In fact, many kinds of devices like these have been put into practice in many countries.
But that's business to business after all. To be practical, what kind of profit can we gain?
With your international assistance, it can not only raise Taiwan's international prestige, but also increase the visibility of your company.
Most importantly, the delight from helping people and the sense of achievement.It's more precious.
Sounds perfect. Since it's such a beneficial proposal, I'm willing to give the try. Our production department will be responsible for the remaining part.
Thanks for your great assistance!
We've already completed the task. I believe solar backpacks will bring locals there for convenience by our excellent solar energy specialty. Come on in, guys!
The matter should not be delayed. Let's wait for breaking up also!
Whoa!
Yes, it gets dark after sunset, and we can do nothing at all. Who can help us?
Don't worry. See what we bring for you.
Wow, a brand new backpack. But how can it solve the problem of generating electricity?
It's not just a backpack. It's a high-tech product integrating Taiwan's great solar technology.
Yes, just turn on the light on the backpack at night. And you don't have to tolerate the darkness anymore.
In this way, I can not only do some housework, but improve the quality of learning environment. I think our future will be as bright as this light. I'm so grateful for what you've done for us. By the way, where do you come from?
We are from Taiwan. We barely make it.
Never sell yourself short. As long as we are full of patience, we can make a little change to the world, even though we are just senior high students.
And originality and creativity can bring turning point for this world. Take a combination of solar technology and backpacks, for example. This represents the soft power of Taiwan in the world.
Furthermore, teenagers' international care can not only broaden their horizons, but also make contributions to the life of the people in the world.
Perhaps it's not a matter you didn't do it, but it's always honorable if you
do it!
Bob.
Thank you.
9队携带证件到第一准备区，6队请上台。6队的表演题目是 Diplomatic Dimensions， 计时开始。
This is the diplomatic dimension. An audience is on my power. You are about to see a dimension that is beyond what is known to man.Inside Solar Guide, when we close ourselves to the world, and what can happen when we open our hearts and minds. You have just crossed into the Twilight Zone.
Hey everyone, how's the brainstorming?
Oh, we're finished!
That's good. What have you decided?
We're going to make a smart desk.
That sounds interesting. How does it work?
Well, during class, students have questions for the teacher, but they're too shy to ask.
With a smart desk, students can type their questions into the desk and send them to the teacher to see during the lesson. That's amazing!
Well done, guys!
Awesome!
That could be useful, but this is an international competition. Zoe and Candy, you went to Australia a few years ago. What did you tell me was different about classes there?
Your classes?
Less homework!
Today team!
Volleyball club!
Beaches surfing!
And the students often ask questions in class.
Well, group, it's your decision. Think carefully.
Thank you, sir.
What do you think, Zoe?
I'm afraid he might be right.
Is this something people use in France or maybe India?
But desk idea is good. We can place everyone around the world.
We all agree that the desk is a good idea.
So what's the problem? We put another thought into this and agreed this is the way to go. Why change now?
Because we can't find something else to do, Theo. There are many problems around the world. Look!
Look? Look at all the work we did. Do you want to go there again? We don't have the time. I say we vote. Those in favor of keeping our ideas, say aye. Aye. Come on, Candy.
I like your idea, Theo. But we can find something that helps people everywhere. If we work together, we should have enough time.
Yeah.
As you can see, failure. Now, let's try again by speeding ahead to the keywords and giving them some diplomatic energy.
Hey, what are the best on me?
Oh, look at it!
Let's get over to the side.
Oh, it's my life.
That's my teacher.
Has more requests than class students, of course, but teacher, but the teacher says,
ah!
International competition. So you can use it to show that you're good. What did you tell Mr. Blue about classes here?
What about 18?
Go, go, go!
We just said that!
Oh, yes.
Students often ask questions in class.
Well, group, it's your decision. Think carefully.
Thank you, sir. What do you think, Zoe? I'm afraid he might be right. Is this something people use in France or maybe India?
The desk idea is good. But is there another way to help more people?
There must be something else we can do. There are many problems around the world. Look! Studies show students with internet access do better in school. Okay! So what?
So we could make something that brings the internet to more people.
That does sound like something we can do.
You're right. We'll have to work quickly. But I think we can do it.
Well, let's get started.
And the first place winner for design and innovation is Taiwan!
Wow!
Your creation of a bicycle-powered computer that generates a Wi-Fi signal can be used by countless number of people in numerous countries all around the world!
Yeah!
Being flexible, having the right attitude, and being open to new possibilities are necessary qualities for anyone trying to adopt a global mindset. What we have witnessed is what can happen when we close ourselves to the world around us. Please keep this in mind as you leave the Twilight Zone.
10队携带证件到第一准备区，7队请上台。7队的表演题目是《A Drop of Love, A Change for the Better》。计时开始。
Makes
people glad. I wish that we had seen the sky up above. We'll stay abundant forever.
Honey,
what's going on?
Our baby keeps crying and crying. She's got diarrhea 2 days ago, and now it seems like she's got high fever. Honey, will she leave us?
It must be the dirty water. We need a workable solution. It's a problem not only here, but everywhere here in our country.
Clean water is getting less and less. Why is getting clean water such a daily struggle for us? If only someone could help us.
Don't worry, honey. I'll figure something out. Let's go to the doctor first.
House number 26, that's 23, 24, and 25. So it must be the next one.
Oh, here it is! Oops, I'm sorry! Are you alright?
Well, I'm fine. Hey, you must be Jocelyn, the youth ambassador of Water for Life from Taiwan.
Yes, I am! You're Adam, right?
Yes, I work for Project H, and you?
I work for Project A.
Ha! I must find some clean water for my poor girl.
So, what are you doing with the water here?
I'm testing the water with a water cannery. It's an extremely easy and portable device for testing water purity. I'm assigned to teach a local people to use it.
Oh, cool!
And how about you? What brings you here?
I've got a bottle called the Lifesaver.
Wow. Lifesaver.
This is awesome, too.
And what is it for?
It's kind of a funeral.
What are you doing here on my farm? Are you stealing my water?
Oh, no, 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 sir. We are the youth ambassador of Water for Life from Taiwan.
Ha! We are here to help you.
I don't need any help from anyone. Get off my land. Every drop of water is precious to us.
Sir, please give us 5 minutes. I'll show you how useful the water cannery is.
Yes, sir. That device can prevent you from using dirty water. Besides...
No way! Leave us alone!
Honey, what's all the commotion? What's going on?
These two strangers are trying to steal our water.
Ma'am, there must be some misunderstanding.
Trust us. We're here to help you. Honey, I think maybe we can give them a chance to show us what they've got.
Well, thank you. This is cold water cannery. The light turns red as soon as I fill it with dirty water.
I don't believe him.
And if the water is clean, the light turns green.
That's
it's
amazing.
Easy to operate and it doesn't use any chemicals. It's the fastest way to test water purity.
Really? Our baby girl gets diarrhea every other week. We've been looking for solutions to help her.
Apart from the water cannery, we also have this.
What's that?
It's a Lifesaver bottle. I know that diarrhea is common here because of the unclean water. Now, all you need is an easy way to get clean water.
How does it work?
Let me give you a bit of demonstration. Lifesaver pores are 15 nanometers, so none of the pollutants that make you sick get through. First, you just scoop the filthy water up and put it in here. Then give it a few pumps. That's all that's necessary. Pure drinking water is coming out. There you go.
It tastes really nice. Honey, this can save our lives. Try it.
Fine. Wow, is this really our water?
Yes.
That's amazing. There are people dying here every day in our village because of the dirty water. You guys are lifesavers to us.
It's our pleasure. With water canneries
and lifesaver bottles,
let's make a change and live a joy.
请上台。 第八队的表演题目是 Taiwan Embrace the World， 计时开始。
Hey, I'm back. April, you know we're Taiwanese, and we should focus on helping the people in Taiwan. There are thousands of Taiwanese in need, and all you care about is helping other people in other countries.
Are you really saying that non-Taiwanese people don't deserve our help? There are people everywhere, and everyone
needs help.
We should
start by helping people here in Taiwan. I don't think we have the time or money to help everyone all over the world.
You're so limited. There are many people suffering from hunger, illnesses, disease, poverty. They all need us. Fine, we hardly ever see eye to eye. So let me keep working.
Hey, look, I'm sorry. I understand what you mean. We should help all people.
You finally understand.
I love you. You're the best thing that ever happened. And you're the only one I want to share the rest of my life with.
Well, my plan's probably not what you're expecting. I've been studying up on a Qigong flea and how I can help solve this problem.
Ah, yes, I've heard of that. The Tangan Panan Trance, also known as the Qigong flea. Actually, it can burrow anywhere on a person. Hands, elbows, rather quite nasty.
Yeah, if this Qigong flea burrows into your feet, it often leaves permanent damage. Heavy infestation may lead to serious complication, amputation, even death.
Well, it does sound like you found your calling. When are you leaving?
I'm going to Africa tomorrow! Hey, I've cleaned and dressed the wounds, and these are for you. Go ahead.
Thank you.
My dad once bought back shoes many years ago. He said they were a present from a Taiwanese couple.
That was probably my parents.
They have been collecting shoes from Taiwanese people and sending them to Central and South America, India, and Africa since they're married.
Hi.
Hey, that's them. They're actually arriving anytime now.
Really?
My parents once told me that if we do something with our heart, we will always do our best.
Your family seems truly extraordinary.
There's lots of people in Taiwan doing this. This keeps us humble. It makes us proud. You should come visit us.
I would love to visit.
Hi, Rebecca.
Hi, Mom, Dad. This is my friend Jennifer.
Hello, Rebecca's parents. I can't believe I finally get to meet you. We'll always be grateful to you. And now your daughter's helping us.
My wife once taught me the value of helping others. She opened my eyes. What can I say? She taught me to embrace life.
I'm going to get her luggage.
Dad, I'm starting a health and education center. And I also want to take Jennifer back to Taiwan and show her our culture and food.
Oh, God, I miss our food.
I can't wait. When you come back to Africa, we'll show you our village's finest.
Well, it is my belief that this is how we come together. Economically, that is how it works. You see, it runs on production and utilization of
food. Dad, don't forget what Mom already taught you. Let's go to Taiwan, Jennifer.
Mom, let's go.
This is absolutely stunning.
Really? It's just the Taiwanese way.
If I may ask, what are your ideas for our village?
Well, Rebecca's already done it. A base. A place for shoes and repairs, a place for education, treatment, and prevention.
It's about sharing fish and teaching people how to fish.
All we have to do is continue helping each other.
Well, Mom, to really make it happen, we need to continually raise funds, generate income, and balance our lives so that we can build a sustainable center.
We can do it, and our village will love you.
We already do.
I have many friends, and there are many charities in Taiwan. Remember, we have have been doing this for so many years.
If we work hard, we'll soon be able to help others.
I do believe it is exactly as you just said. It's how we build our societies together.
We can be grateful to embrace challenges and difficult times.
We can truly embrace life and to embrace the world.
Taiwan, embrace love! Taiwan, embrace the world!
Thank you!
九队请上台。第九队的表演题目是 Little Chocolate, Big Changes, 计时开始。
Zoe, see the chocolate I got? This is yummy.
Looking at a chocolate bar, it reminds me of the news that I read today. Those cocoa farmers in Ivory Coast have never tasted any chocolates before.
Why so? Isn't chocolate made from the cocoa?
Yes, however,94% of its profit does not go to those farmers. They have to work 12 to 14 hours a day and get by less than $1.25.
That's even below absolute poverty. I hope I can do something for them. Maybe we can donate money for those farmers.
Yes, let's do it!
The money is for you guys.
With the money, you guys can have a better life.
Thank you, but... But there are already some other people who have done what you did, and the money doesn't really help at all.
The money came in handy at first, but then everything would go back to normal, and we still have to work like we used to.
We're sorry. Come and work if you want to help.
Work like this every single day?
Of course! Did you see these cocoa beans? We need to work all day long because we have a certain goal to reach and a lot of process to go through.
I finally know how tiring this is.
If we had machines...
Yes! Machines!Why don't you guys have machines?
With machines, you can work more efficiently.
Machines will become old. Machines need to be repaired.
Yeah, and it's not a problem that can be solved with one donation.
Oh, wait. Maybe microloan will help.
What's that?
It's a project called Microloan Bank, which helps the needy live a better life.
But how is it different from a conventional bank?
With conventional banks, you need a certain deposit to get a loan, while microloan banks don't. Moreover, microloan banks provide the needy an interest-free platform to start their business.
It seems like a sustainable method. We should tell everyone about this information.
Yes! How about sharing the websites?
But there are only a few of internet users here in Ivory Coast.
Yeah, I heard there's only like 6% of them.
Maybe a picture booklet would be more practical.
Yes! Like this?
Yes! And on the first page should be how to get in contact with the bank.
These are the locations where people can fill in applications that give their jobs. Then the microloan banks will post it on the website so that it can be available to millions of lenders.
should be about a specific machine.
With this peeling machine, we don't have to peel the cocoa beans by hand. And that is a machine that can turn residues into water. With this, we don't need to get water from far, far away anymore.
And there are also cocoa bean roasting machines, which can save up 5 to 12 days that we originally need.
What's more, you won't need to worry about how to pay the money back to the bank. The employees from the bank, who are in contact with you while you foster your business, will come to collect the money from you.
Instead of giving them fish,
we taught them how to fish.
Because of the introduction of microloan bank
and education of what kind of machines to buy,
now you can have a better life!
Bow.
10队请上台。第十队的表演题目是 Inspiration， 计时开始。
Hi, I'm Gail.
Hey, girls.
Hey, girls. How's school today?
It's great. We learned a lot in school today. Our teachers gave us a few assignments about programs to help the needy.
Yeah, and she encouraged us to come up with our own ideas for similar programs to help those who are in need. Wow, I'm so impressed by what schools are teaching these days.So, what have you guys planned so far?
I've been thinking.
We've been thinking about helping Nepal.
It had a devastating earthquake not too long ago.
And so many other places need help. We want to help too. Mm.
Wow, that's really inspiring to hear your dreams, especially you're so young. Yeah, I'm so proud of you kids. I'm really glad you guys are trying to change the world.
Yeah, your aunt, she's going to Nepal next week to rebuild all the houses and buildings.
Oh, that sounds so exciting!
Yeah, and I'm going with her.
Oh, Mom, I really want to go with you.
Please?
No, you can't go with me. You have schoolwork. I won't let you sacrifice your education for less. Maybe when you're older, but focus on your schoolwork for now.
But Mom, we're not children anymore.
That's not right. We can be doing so much more, Mom. I don't want to stay here and I could be making a difference and helping the people in Nepal. Okay, I'll make a deal with you girls. I'll take you guys next year. It's rewarding, but not just fun and games. Is that okay?
Please.
Yeah, fine, okay.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you, Aunt Gail.
No.
this is Laura Lee, and you're watching CBS News. Today, I'm here with Nancy and Jane, two teenagers who have accomplished great things. Tell me, ladies, you have successfully tried to rebuild one of the worst affected villages here in Nepal. What inspired you to help others so selflessly?
Well, I can't say it was completely selfless. Our major inspiration was definitely our dear aunt. Determination also drove us to where we are today.
But you two are so young. What made you think you could accomplish so much?
There were obstacles, but we were working towards our dreams. Our aunt believed in us, and we believed in ourselves.
Youth today see you as role models and leaders of tomorrow. Do you have anything inspiring to say to our audience today?
Yes. Don't ever give up or put yourself down. You may be young, but that does not mean you're not capable. Believe in yourself.
Chase after your dreams before it's too late.
Wow, that's incredible. Thank you. I'm here with Nancy and Jane, two teenagers who proved to the world that youth can, in fact, change the world. This is Laura Lee signing off from CBS News.
Thank you.
好的，现在的时间是10:11，那请第11、12还有13队在10:20携带证件到第一准备区。那我们现在休息到10:30。不过请大家在10:25的时候回到摄影棚就坐，谢谢大家，休息吧，小心地上的麦克风。